have memories.
Try this council thing. I got fellas low key chilling. I wanted to show them this game and the choices and stuff. It's episode one. You know, it's for free. And I've been talking about it like hell. So, we gonna do this.
You're not getting anywhere with this, von Borchert.
You know, I kind of get the same feeling, my dear Sarah. Listen. Nothing. Not a sound. No one's coming to save you.
That's what you think. The Golden Order knows exactly where we are.
By the time your ridiculous secret society turns up, I'll be long gone.
As you play it.
For you, nothing will remain of your body.
If you touch a single hair on my mother's head, I'll skin you alive.
Totally.
No, Louis. I have no intention of beating your dear mother. There are more persuasive ways of making you talk. You've stolen something from me that I intend to get back. Where have you hidden it?
Von Borchert, you can't sell that book on the black market anymore. This is finished.
We know you're planning on selling at one of Lord Mortimer's parties. All right? Just tell us who the buyer is and we can make a deal.
You've no idea of the trouble you've gotten yourselves into. Oh, but you will tell me where it's hidden. I can promise you that.
Stop annoying our host, Louis. Son, didn't what happened to you in Rome teach you anything?
Just a few more minutes and my concoction will be ready. With this, your bodies will dissolve in less than 4 hours. You'll see. It loosens tongues in no time.
You know, I have to admit, Mother, the only thing you've ever taught me is that damn motto of yours. Always remain rational and open. I got it. I've opened our shackles.
Draw him over here. I'll take care of him.
Von Borchert! Von Borchert! Listen! Let's make a deal. I'll tell you where the book is if you let my mother go free.
Oh, what are you playing at?
Don't worry, Mother.
You want to play the hero. Pity you're not in any position to do so. For the last time. Where is Alazif?
Let me do this. Trust me.
Right. Act or trust her?
Please, be my guest, Mother.
Are you gonna still try to fight her even though she has a gun? And can shoot? Well, there's a chair.
Well done, Louis. You reacted perfectly.
How do you feel, Mother?
Couldn't be better. He's alive, so I can question him after we get back. Pity he's just a middleman. Means I haven't finished with this case.
Oh, I had a feeling you'd be running off on one of your adventures again, Mother. You know what? I'm warning you. This time, I'm coming with you.
No. Even though you impress me more and more, I have to do this on my own.
Mother, you're no spring chicken anymore.
Come on, let's go home. And don't forget to send our men to tend to von Borchert.
Use the golden elixir to delete the negative altercation. Okay. 1 month later, January 20th, 1793. Lord Mortimer's Island, off the coast of England. A game by Big Bad Wolf Studio.
Well done, Mother. You just had to pick up von Borchert's trail on your own, didn't you? You ditch me in Paris with no explanation, and off you go to infiltrate one of the world-renowned receptions of this Lord Mortimer, and now he writes me to say that you've gone missing on his private island? Which, by the way, looks more like a big rock than a paradise island.
The least he could do is explain to me how he managed to lose you. In any case, it is time for you to stop all this, Mother. It no longer suits your age. Well, I'm sure I'll find you once again, slogging through the caves beneath the island, searching for some long-lost mystical object that you just can't live without. I'm already hating this trip, and all I've done is think about it.
Contrary to what one may be able to imagine, it was not the host himself who invited me.
Well now, Duchess, we find ourselves both invited by Sir Holm.
Well, how very amusing. Perhaps we have some common interests, Your Eminence. Is this your first time at one of Lord Mortimer's legendary parties?
Oh, no. We have been friends since long ago. But as I'm doing some business with Sir Holm, the invitation came from him.
Well, I simply can't wait for all the festivities to begin.
And you, good sir, what brings you here?
Lord Mortimer asked me to join him. We have some business to take care of.
Oh, how mysterious. You adapt quickly, my son. You get along here like a fish in water. Would you believe that we are all here hoping to solve our personal issues? You'll see.
Right. I doubt that you came here to look for your mother, Your Eminence.
Anyway, consider yourself fortunate, young man, because there are many who dream of simply one day setting foot on this island, and only a very few ever make it. Indeed. I imagine this must be your first time here.
And you, Duchess? You seem to be quite accustomed to things here. Am I right?
I do not think that one can ever get accustomed to what Lord Mortimer prepares for his guests. But you are right. This is not the first time I've been on this wharf.
If you've come back again, I imagine you must find it to be of some interest.
Here, everything is possible if you make the right choices. It really is up to you whether you leave better off or not.
Please excuse me if you find me overly curious, young man. I did not mean to cause you any embarrassment. Come, Duchess. They are waiting for us.
We're moving, Monsieur de Richet, if you would like to join us.
I'm coming, Duchess. A cardinal? A duchess? I wonder if all the guests here are this prestigious. If I'd known, I would have gone for a better suit.
Are you all right?
The hell?
Mother? Oh shit, your hand!
So,
Okay, it's done.
Did you put it in a safe place?
Yes. I made sure no one was following me. Don't worry, Sarah. No one's going to find it.
Are you absolutely sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
Right. Just one thing left to do.
No, Mother! No! Don't!
What? Have you lost your mind?
There is no other way.
If you kill me, you won't find it.
That is the point, my dear. No one must ever put their hands on it again.
No. But I trusted you.
No, Sarah. Don't! No. No! You can run if you want to, Sarah. But you will pay for what you've done.
You.
Louis, are you all right? What's going on?
His nose bleeding like a motherfucker.
Here, take this.
I'm sorry.
Keep it. Are you better?
I'm fine. Don't worry. It's getting late. Why don't you go on ahead and I'll catch up with you, okay?
Are you sure?
Yes! I'm sorry. I'm sure, yes.
Fine.
I definitely have to find Mother quickly.
Am I going crazy or what? This can't be real. The Duchess arrived with me. What's happening to me, for God's sake? I absolutely need to find you, Mother.
Okay. Okay, so I can't run. Okay.
Louis, during the trip, I had something I wanted to ask you, but we didn't happen to run into each other.
Yes, Duchess?
I'm not sure if you remember, but we've met before. At that time, you were of two minds as to your choice of career. Tell me, what have you been up to since?
Okay, so you gotta choose a class. Diplomat, occultist, detective. Let's go with Chotis. Hold up, which one of these do I really want? Okay, so I see what's going on. Oh, okay, I see what's going on. So all of these are level one already. Okay. Thank you. I'll see what's going on. Skill use is free. So that's the only other stuff I have right now. Okay. Okay. Let's go like that then.
I have been involved in all sorts of unsolved cases. Have you ever heard of the Abbey of Hexham?
Vaguely.
An ingenious scam involving mass manipulation on a scale never seen before.
There was a cavern under the abbey, wasn't there?
Exactly. The wind would blow in through spouts, creating a terrifying howling sound. So, to stop the howling, the priests called for offerings from the peasants.
And if they brought enough money, I'm guessing the priests stopped the howling. A perfect trick to fool simple souls.
Admit it, Duchess. That story kept you in suspense, didn't it?
Yes, it did. I'm delighted to find out that you were the young and brilliant French investigator.
For someone who only remembers the case vaguely, your memories are very clear.
Well, they say I have the memory of two people. But please, call me Emily.
Fine, Emily. Tell me, I was actually helped on that case by my mother. You wouldn't know her by any chance.
Wait, Louis. We've already met. You do remember me, don't you?
How could I forget a woman such as yourself?
A woman such as me? What a sweet talker you are. Remind me of how we met.
Your skills give you access to unique choices and actions at the cost of effort points. The higher your skill level, the lower the cost. Okay.
Emily, it hurts me that you could doubt my sincerity. I thought we'd gotten past that stage by now.
Don't take it like that, Louis. I was only joking. I thought you were making fun of me.
I thought you were someone I could trust. I'm hurt to see that you're still at the stage of testing me, Duchess.
Listen, Louis, I am sorry. I really didn't want to hurt you. Forget what I just said. It was clumsy of me.
If you say so.
Let's go with that, then. Didn't see me, didn't know me. Push any harder and I'll make a fool of myself.
Right, time to go to the manor.
Your skills allow you to discover hidden details. Select the object that is most suggestive of the situation or to discover them. Opportunities do not consume effort points to access the skill required for that situation. You just need to have it unlocked. Okay.
I ask her a question. She answers with another. Is she playing with me?
Okay. Each person you meet on the island has their own personality, which makes them vulnerable to certain skills and immune to others. Exploiting their personality is crucial to achieve your personal goals. Skill used against immunities will not succeed and will leave you exhausted. Meanwhile, exploited vulnerabilities will give you one extra point back. Review. Okay.
Emily, please excuse my insisting, but you still haven't answered about my mother. Do you know her?
You'll see, Louis. Everybody here knows Sarah de Richet.
I don't know where we're going like this, Emily, but you're connected to my mother one way or another. And if I can believe my vision, you don't have much of a place in her heart.
You obtain talents when carrying out certain actions. Remember to review their unlock conditions and effects as they offer very interesting improvements. Okay.
Must be an incredible view from up there. Impossible to set foot on the island without being seen from 300 meters away.
Royal jelly. Okay.
Great, honey.
So that's how you get effort points back. And you can't carry any more than 5. Okay.
Good evening, sir. May I ask your name, please?
Louis Moras de Richet.
Monsieur de Richet, delighted to welcome you among us, sir. You must be Sarah de Richet's son. I must tell you, we are doing our utmost to find your mother as quickly as possible.
What can you tell me about the disappearance of my mother?
2 weeks have passed since Sir's mother went missing. All the staff here have since been busy searching every nook and cranny of the island. But Sir may rest assured, we shouldn't be long in finding her.
And just what have you found so far?
It would seem that Sir's mother may be hiding on the island, and regularly changing her location. But no one seems to know why she would find this behavior necessary.
What do you mean?
On several occasions, we have found leftovers of food, a few of her things, or even traces of campsites. The reason why we're searching the wharf again is because lights were spotted there last night.
Where we are now?
Indeed, sir. According to our information, lights were seen in the middle of the night, sir. After verification, none of the guests seem to have left the manor last night. We think that perhaps Sir's mother was here.
Interesting.
Did anyone see anything else?
Unfortunately not, sir. Only lights were seen by servants of the manor, sir. And as I was saying, sir, all the guests were asleep, and no one seems to have noticed anything at all. We seem to have found an object that would appear to belong to Sir's mother. A handkerchief. The handkerchief is embroidered with the initials SDR. We came to the conclusion that they are the initials of Sir's mother, Sarah de Richet. I have orders to give it to Lord Mortimer as soon as I see him.
I know my mother. She's not the kind to go for a midnight stroll on the wharf for nothing. I've got to find out what the hell she was doing here. Where exactly did you find the handkerchief?
On the landing dock, sir. The one you arrived by.
Okay.
Pass me the handkerchief.
But sir, my orders were to give it to my master.
Are you refusing to give me my own mother's personal belongings? Even though she was greatly looking forward to meeting your master, she's gone missing. And you seem incapable of finding her.
Oh, but sir, please.
And to top it all off, you refuse to give me the handkerchief that she so often let me use? Do I deserve such little consideration in your eyes? Is that what you wish me to report to your master?
No, certainly not, sir. Please forgive me, sir. I have been such an idiot. Here you are.
Well, thank you.
It is indeed your handkerchief, mother. You must have come here for a specific reason. I need to know what it is. Let's think. What could she have been doing out here on this wharf? No way I'm leaving without finding out about Mother.
Okay, so let's just go back over there. Wait.
This chest might belong to Duchess Hillsborough. Some rope. Apparently no one's touched it for a good long time. A lantern. Nothing special. Let's see what's hidden inside. Let's look.
Okay, let's see. So you need 5 left.
too badly written. I can't make out the address.
A letter written in an oriental language. I haven't the slightest idea what it says. The address is 50 Bedford Square, London.
I'm actually glad they do that.
He's in Sao Paulo, Brazil. That reminds me, it's about time the order sent some envoys there. Samuel Ritter d'Auchois. Mother, you test me even when you're not here. It's an anagram of Louis Moras de Richet. You wanted to write to me then. Let's see what's inside this letter. So.
Dear Samuel, my stay on Lord Mortimer's island is going wonderfully well. As I find myself in such charming company, I plan to stay a few more weeks. Would you be so kind as to send me a gift that I'd like to give to our old friend Manuel Godoy? I would be most grateful. I have been told that he's going to join us here soon. I would like to mark the occasion. Thank you in advance. Yours devotedly, Sarah Faustine de Richet.
What is your game here, Mother? What are these strange turns of phrase? I've never heard you speak like that. What's going on here? That you write to me under a pen name, okay. But here you go even further by trying to avoid raising any suspicions should anyone else read it. I wonder if this Godoy is the person you came looking for. Think. Godoy, Godoy. Manuel Godoy. Why does the name sound so familiar? I'm guessing he's a man of some importance. Spanish, I'd say. But just can't put a face to him. Well, hope we meet to talk about it soon, Mother. I don't know what you've gotten yourself into this time, but I'll bet you've got a lot to tell me.
Hey.
Let's see what's hidden inside.
I got some more letters.
Let's look. Letter written in an oriental language. I haven't the slightest idea what it says. Probably a Dutchman. An address in Cairo, Egypt. Mortimer communicates with the whole world, apparently.
Oh, shit. I hit the wrong damn shit.
Address is 50 Bedford Square, London.
So when this happens, can't you... I would think you should be able to skip some of this, if you already did it.
This envelope is meant for the Vatican. Apparently this letter is meant for Pope Pius VI, born Giovanni Bracci. I wonder which one of these people is influential enough to write to the Pope in person. The address is in Sao Paulo, Brazil. That reminds me, it's about time the order sent some envoys there.
Okay. That should be it. See if we can head towards the back, I guess. Wait.
Great, honey.
Hey, there's something not right about this floorboard. It's different from the rest. Somebody replaced it recently. But looks like it's fixed pretty solidly in place. It's going to be tough to rip it out of here.
Oh, shit! It's not coming up. I'll never manage it barehanded. I need something to lever it with.
There's something around that I could use. Wait, I'm looking.
Locked. I'll never get it open barehanded. There we are.
All right.
This wharf is used as storage for a lot of barrels.
Uh-huh. What have we here? It's cannon powder.
The powder's wet. Not surprising, given the dampness of the dock.
It's unusable now. I don't know what the person who left this barrel like this had in mind, but it's a waste. This looks like a pistol case. But it's empty. I don't know if this has anything to do with you, Mother, but if it does, at least now you're armed. Just like in my vision. And none of it's telling me anything useful. Apparently, someone on this island has gone through a whole lot of trouble to arm themselves. I really must find you, dear Mother, and quickly, too.
Okay.
Somebody replaced it recently. But looks like it's fixed pretty solidly in place. It's going to be tough to rip it out of here.
Oh, shit! It's not coming up. I'll never manage it barehanded. I need something to lever it with.
Wait. Okay. That was coins.
Looks like the barrel's been broken for quite some time.
Here we go.
Looks like a bar from an old gate. This miserable old bar has been broken fairly recently. The edges are still clean, and the tip is blackened. Without analysis to the contrary, I put my money on cannon powder. This might just come in handy. A sack of seeds. It's unopened. No one seems to have used any.
That
That does it. Let's see what's hidden inside.
There's a book and also a bag. The Mysterium Cosmographicum. I know that book well. Mother used to read passages from it to me all the time.
And judging from what I can see, it's the same one as hers. For crying out loud, what's happened to you, Mother?
Manuscripts allow you to educate yourself during the adventure. At the start of each quest, you can choose what to read and gain permanent skill points. Okay.
Let's look inside the bag. A little food, a few toiletries, a small key, and some kind of black powder. Some fruit, a piece of bacon, and some bread. The fruit's still firm. The bread's a bit stale. From the smell, this food's been here roughly 2 days, and if it's rationed, there's enough left to last 2 more days. Shit, those are definitely my mother's things. I recognize her hairpins. This bag smells of her perfume, a piece of soap, some oils, and her powder puff. What does all this mean? The bottom of the bag is covered in black powder. And judging by its consistency, it's the same type of powder that I found earlier. This just gets better and better. An iron key, completely rusted. You never know. It might be useful. I hope Mother wasn't counting on it.
Okay. Let's see here. So how do I... Okay, so... Wait.
Right, that's enough. I think I better leave her bag here. If she hid all this, it's because she thought she might need it later. So, let's go through this. My mother's been hiding pieces of bread between the rotten boards of a wharf in the middle of the night. That's not normal. And if that weren't enough, looks now like she's armed. Meanwhile, she also takes the time to send out letters, reassuring whoever might be interested that she's having a fabulous time here. So odd. So very odd. And that's not even all I've noticed. But maybe I ought to move on to the manor now. They'll be waiting for me. At least I hope so.
Okay. Talent. Wait. No, that's not what I'm looking for. Okay, this is what I'm looking for. So, how do I... Okay. All right, let's head on in, I guess. Wait.
Latin inscription. En nesis, mi fili quantilia produncia mundus regatur. You don't know, my son, how little wisdom the world is governed with. I tend to agree.
Up to the manor.
How did Mortimer manage to build his manor at the top of a rocky outcrop?
Okay. I'm in the manor.
Impressive.
Ah, my son. I was looking for you.
What can I do for you, Your Eminence?
I wanted to ask you. You are the son of Sarah de Richet, aren't you? You see, your mother and I were supposed to meet here on this very spot. I was supposed to hand her a very important envelope. But I haven't seen her.
If only Mother had told me why she was coming here. Anyway, I ought to take the envelope. It might have something to do with her disappearance. Listen, if it will help,
always
give it to me.
During confrontation, you have to go through several steps while being as persuasive as possible. Confrontations have consequences on the rest of the story, so don't hesitate to use your skills. Each confrontation displays an interface showing how much the person you are talking to is convinced. Okay.
Thank you, my son. I'll bear that in mind. I'd rather deal with her directly. Don't take it personally. Would you happen to know if your mother has arrived yet?
Certainly, Your Eminence. Mother got here some time ago. I was hoping to find her when I arrived, but given the hour, she must be asleep by now.
You're right. I shall see her tomorrow, then.
By the way, Your Eminence, I wasn't aware you knew my mother.
Ah, if you only knew, my son. I hold your mother in the highest regard. She has rendered great service to the church, and her help is invaluable. I hope that you will follow in her footsteps.
If only she had told me where she was headed.
Nonetheless, our exchanges have always been discreet, and I should like them to remain as such. If your mother wishes to speak to you about us one day, I will not mind if she does so.
That is very commendable. But since we work together on a daily basis, it's surely just an oversight.
Most certainly. You said you work together. What do you do exactly?
Be it Mother or myself, our motto has always been discretion in all things, and to promise to never betray a word of honor. Was your secret safe with Mother? It will be even more so with me.
You have convinced me. The mystery with which your mother manages her business proves that she carries your motto close to her heart. Your words seem sincere, my son.
All the same, it bothers me to see you in a quandary, Your Eminence. Is there any other solution? Look, if it's of any help, you can always leave your envelope with me, and I'll give it to her as soon as I see her.
I hesitate. Up till now, we have always dealt with her in person, and that has always been successful. Do you think I should give it to you?
Actually, yes, I do.
Don't worry, Your Eminence. Your secret is safe with me. You know my mother's reputation. As her son, I will defend the Richet's word with the same fervor.
Ah, I would expect nothing less. Listen to me, my child. If I give you the letter, can you promise me before God that no one other than your mother would read it?
For the last step of conversation, you must convince the person you are talking to by giving a positive answer. If you give a bad answer, the step will repeat itself until either you give a right one or you have no blunders left. The last step of a conversation will repeat itself if you fail.
Your Eminence, that's just not possible for me.
Why is that?
I've always had a Cartesian mind, and I won't make false promises. I respect you too much for that. I spend my time trying to find logical and reasonable answers to problems which, at first glance, may seem supernatural. I'm not saying I don't believe in God as a concept. I just don't believe in the God of your sacred texts. And I don't want to lie to you.
Even though your answer does shock me, my son, I shall only hear your honesty. Listen, let's stop there. I'm going to tell you a secret, Monsieur Richet. Your mother and I are organizing the escape of a large number of French priests who face a massacre organized by the accursed Republican tribunals. The church is literally being bled like a beast.
Wow.
Without your mother, hundreds of men of the cloth have gone to the guillotine. She has made the services of your order available to us by organizing the priests' safe passage across the borders. Even if she does not share all our convictions, she always provided assistance. Young man, you can be proud to be her son. Be it only for her sake. Always respect your name. Here, the letter I spoke of. It includes a list of about 15 names ready for departure. Be quick. Remember to tell Sarah when you see her that time is short.
Well played. I'll decide later when I'm alone whether to look at what it contains.
Hidden elements. Many clues and items are hidden. Some of them will have an impact on your adventure, so do not hesitate to look for them. Okay. The letter is sealed, and I'm out of jelly. You have used 4 consumable items during a secret quest to consume the noxious element. Dialogue timer is no longer visible. Use a gold elixir to cure yourself. I don't think I have one of them. Okay. That was the one grants you love to state. You triple A see the immunities and vulnerabilities affecting a dialogue choice in a conversation. You cannot carry any more than 5. Okay. Well, that's helpful.
Fall of the Damned by Rubens. The man who cannot achieve the salvation of God the Father is offered to fall into the depths of the abyss. Blind Oedipus. Blinded himself. What a tragic destiny.
That's the way out.
Lord Mortimer certainly has a taste for staging rooms. Saturn devouring his son. Good God, how awful. Everything in this painting is disturbing. It's the first time I've seen brushstrokes like this. Crucifixion of St. Peter. He was crucified upside down out of humility. Surprising for an entrance hall.
Did I look at all of them already? I think I did.
Lives of the Noble Greeks and Romans by Plutarch. Biography of the Great Men. Open to Brutus's page. Caesar,
stabbed by multiple blows at once, sees Brutus raise the dagger on him. Then, covering his head with his robe, he delivers himself to the arms of the conspirators. Nice family. Let's keep it. Might come in handy someday.
True. Good read.
I thought my chimney was big, but this one is beyond belief.
It's the least one can say. I've been longing for a warm fire for ages.
Since I set foot on the island, I haven't ventured more than 2 yards away from it.
Have you also just arrived?
Oh, late morning, I'd say.
Louis, come join us. Monsieur, may I introduce you to Monseigneur His Eminence, Cardinal Piaggi. He joins us straight from Rome.
Oh, just call me Your Eminence. It's simpler.
George Washington, President of the United States of America.
Delighted at last to make your acquaintance, Mr. President.
George Washington, the President.
Louis Mouras de Richet. It is an honor to meet you.
Young man, let's keep it simple, please. Let us forget our fancy titles.
All right. Nice to meet you. All right, Joe.
I should imagine you never thought you'd be in such company.
I must admit that I didn't. It's the first time that I've ever met so many illustrious personalities.
And you haven't seen anything yet. Generally, when Lord Mortimer organizes one of his receptions, there are over a dozen people here.
They can't all be here yet. And you'll see, most of the time, there's only the upper crust.
And I noticed you were already getting to know His Eminence at the entrance. It's the perfect place to build up a network. What were you talking about, if you forgive my indiscretion?
At the risk of disappointing you, we weren't conspiring in our corner, sir. His Eminence was simply telling me that he knew my mother and how much he held her in high esteem.
It so happens that Monsieur de Richet's mother is to join us.
Oh, pity. No scrumptious gossip or juicy tidbits, unmentionable secrets, or even money matters. But you'll see, it will come. Despite all the goodwill in the world, you can't stop people scheming left and right around here.
Speak for yourself, sir.
Well, my friends, do any of you know the reason why we're here this time?
Not in the slightest. As for me, I've been invited by Sir Holm, a close friend of Lord Mortimer, but I do not know the reason why.
You see, Louis, every time Lord Mortimer organizes a reception, he always finds a moment to set up a chat with all the guests.
During which time we remake the world.
Accompanied by gallons of absinthe and cussing. I'll leave you to imagine the result.
So, if I understand rightly, Monsieur de Richet, you've come out here to join your mother. For what reason, exactly?
Like you, Mr. President, I'm here as a result of Lord Mortimer's invitation.
Two members of the same family here. That is rare.
You know what they say. You can pick your nose, but you can't pick your family.
Seriously, though, I know your mother well. Stay behind with me afterwards, and we'll take a moment to speak about her.
Everyone seems to know about her.
Good Lord, Washington is wearing the emblem of the Grand Master of the Golden Order. It's the highest distinction of the order in the United States. It puts him on par with my mother. He must really know his stuff when it comes to the occult.
Good evening, my friends.
Holy shit, that's the man for my vision.
An urgent case has delayed our host, Lord Mortimer. He can't be present this evening, and he sends his deepest apologies.
He's asked me here and he hasn't even turned up? Great start.
And now, my dear guests, a light meal is served in the small salon. For those who would like to, you're invited to follow me into the next room.
My dear fellow, you must have read my thoughts. I shall follow.
We'll have to be careful not to make too much noise. One of Lord Mortimer's guests is relaxing.
Oh, we shall be quiet.
Don't take it the wrong way, Sir Holm, but I have already eaten. Thus, I shall be happy to remain by the fireside.
If you don't mind, Gregory, I should like to keep Mr. Washington company.
Please feel at home. And you, sir?
If I stay with Washington, we'll be able to speak about my mother. But on the other hand, I'd like to learn more about this home. I saw him in my vision.
Interesting. Interesting.
Let's see what Washington has to say.
Sir, if you don't mind, I shall stay here.
Do exactly as you please, young man.
Louis, thank you for staying. Just like you, when I arrived this morning, I found out that Sarah had gone missing. I know your mother well. Don't worry. Emily is from the English branch of the Golden Order.
And President Washington is in fact the leader of the Order in the United States.
I didn't know.
Sorry to have made you wait, but I didn't want to speak in front of the others.
You did well. Secrecy and discretion are the pillars of our organization.
If I can help in any way at all, please don't hesitate to ask, my lad. And if you have any other questions, now's the time.
Mother has always had a fascination for Lord Mortimer, but has never wanted to tell me why.
Lord Mortimer is a remarkable man. He's wealthy and is advisor to the very highly placed. Your mother is the head of the Order in France. It doesn't surprise me that he asked her to come.
Lord Mortimer greatly contributed to financing my electoral campaign, for example. But I want this to be clear, without ever seeking to gain an advantage.
And that is to his credit.
Yes, you can trust him. He will do everything in his power to help you find Sarah.
Mr. Washington, you seem to be very familiar with my mother. When did you last speak to her?
Philadelphia, 15 years ago. Sarah often went back and forth between France and the United States.
Yes, I remember those days. I didn't see her too often. Right. Would it be too much if I asked you a few more questions?
Not at all. Go ahead. But I can't promise I'll remember everything.
May I ask, when you saw each other, what did you talk about? When she came to the U.S., did you exchange ideas about the Golden Order?
Exactly. What's more, she was essential in helping set up the American branch of the Order. I would never have become its leader without her help. We are a new country, and to achieve our democratic ideals, we need to count on discrete powers such as our organization.
Thank you, sir.
Well then.
I was hoping to speak with Lord Mortimer. At least now I have some information, thanks to you.
I repeat, Lord Mortimer is a man of his word. You won't be disappointed. And I am persuaded that your mother's research is his main concern.
Mother still is at the head of the Golden Order. I find it difficult to believe that she came to this island without notifying the other members.
As for myself, I did not know. I am here at the request of Sir Holm, a situation regarding the Crown of England to resolve, and to see what Lord Mortimer has to propose to us.
As for me, Lord Mortimer asked me here to speak about the future of America. I did not know that your mother would even be among us. In any case, no one has yet mentioned associating the Order.
We haven't found many clues yet. But I did find a book that belongs to my mother.
Where did you find it?
That's what worries me. I found it hidden on the wharf.
Do you think she was preparing to discreetly leave?
I don't know.
An extremely likely proposition.
I'll believe it when I see it.
Don't worry, Louis. I'm sure nothing bad has happened to her.
Yes, I hope not.
Careful, they're coming back.
Well, I am impressed with all this splendor.
But don't spend too much time with Mr. Washington, my dear, or you'll lose your pretty accent. You seem to be intrigued by that statue.
Absolutely. It is remarkable.
Lord Mortimer is fond of atypical works of art. I won't disguise the fact that I find it all a little megalomaniacal. But I must say, he does have some outstanding pieces.
The statue is impressive, and so are the paintings. Rubens, the Caravage, Guignereau. Lord Mortimer has very good taste, and the means to express it.
Oh, I see our young sir is a connoisseur.
Yes, in my spare time. Yet, I couldn't tell you who the artist of that painting there is. I think I recognize a theme, but the style intrigues me.
Saturn devouring his son. Oh, well, you wouldn't know. The artist is none other than Lord Mortimer. I thought for a long time that the painting wasn't finished, but my old friend assured me it was. Still, there's no accounting for taste.
Not very conventional, but it sure does hold your attention.
You will find that Lord Mortimer is not what one would call conventional, Monsieur de Richet.
Sir Holm, who was that young lady with you?
Elizabeth Adams, Mr. President. She would have liked to have stayed with us, but the poor thing is exhausted.
Elizabeth Adams?
Just mentioning Elizabeth totally changed Washington's attitude. Looks like he just saw a ghost.
Miss Adams is here to rest. You have perhaps already come across her in the corridors. She arrived a few days ago.
I perceived her, but we weren't introduced.
Rest assured, she is not here for the same reasons as yourselves. Consequently, I'm counting on your indulgence. On that note, it's very late. You must be exhausted. The servant will accompany you to your rooms.
Hey.
Ladies, gentlemen, I bid you all good night. Mr. President, Your Eminence, Duchess, you have the same rooms as usual. You, Monsieur de Richet, will find your room at the end of the corridor.
Well, my friends, I am bone tired. I am off to my bed. See you in the morning.
Good night, sir. I shall do likewise.
Louis, I shall see you in the morning. Sleep well.
Good night. See you tomorrow.
Oh, man. It's been quite a day. Right. Where is my room?
Question.
Duchess Emily Hillsborough.
Maybe we can find some stuff around.
Duke Manuel Godoy. That's me. Monseigneur, His Eminence Cardinal Piaggi. President George Washington.
Hey. Say, look around, so we're not telling what we'll find. Okay. I think this is one big circle. Oh boy. Okay. Yeah, it's gotta be. Hey, can I go back down Civ if I want to? Nope. Okay.
Monsieur Johann von Boone now.
Who? I don't even know who that is. You can't go up though. Okay, here we go.
Devil's thorn.
All right.
Guide.
Rules of decision behavior. Wait. Okay, so the more I see what's going on. So, do I just read the books? Okay. Golden elixir. Golden elixir cures all your negative altercations. You cannot carry more than 5.
Golden elixir.
Okay.
A few leaves out of an old encyclopedia.
Okay. And this is why I wanted to look around. That's like a cigar box. Well, case rather.
Jacques Peru. Monsieur Napoléon Bonaparte.
Hmm. Is this 1700s? So it really shouldn't be that surprising. Okay, got another coin.
Duchess Emily Hillsborough.
Okay, so I pretty much made the circle now. So still can't go down. No. Okay. Yeah. Then that's it. Oh boy. Let's see if I can find my room.
Duke Manuel Godoy. What shall I do with this letter? It might be about my mother's disappearance. But if I open it, I'll be betraying Biagi's trust. What should I do?
Open the letter without breaking the seal.
So, it really is a list of French countrymen. Piaggi wasn't lying.
Wow! Nice room. Mortimer sure doesn't do things halfway.
That is true. Culinary water gives you the focus state. Your next skill use will cost no effort. You cannot carry no more than 5.
Light water. They say that if you drink this, it gives you a real boost.
Saint Jerome and the Angel. Yet again, art with political undertones, with an image of a saint hearing voices. Saturn devouring his son. Again? I saw the same theme in the hall. I wouldn't like Saint Francis of Assisi in ecstasy before superior voices. It always amuses me to see how art gets used for propaganda purposes.
Sure.
Golden Elixir.
All right.
Inferno by Dante. Abandon hope, all ye who enter here. Lovely lectures Mortimer's giving to his guests. Very jolly.
I can't get up though.
Inferno by Dante. Abandon hope, all ye who enter here.
Okay. Oh wow, that's pretty cool. Let's see what else is out here. Okay.
Chinese coin.
Okay. So I didn't fail anything. Okay. Okay, so now I have 3 available points. Good. All right. Here, you can choose what to read during an adventure. Each manuscript you read confers skill points at the end of the quest. Okay. Assemble all the pages of this manuscript in order to read. Okay. Now, is there a way for me to... Okay, y'all, we're gonna stop right here. About an hour in, you just jump this off. I just wanted to jump this off and see how it is and everything else. I'm actually enjoying it so far. It's different, I ain't gonna lie. It seems like everything affects everything. All right, also be sure to check out my other content as well. I try to keep everything in playlists and everything. This is part one of episode one of the council on Dark Rilla story based content. An adult-based content creator. Y'all take care of each other. Stay out of bad trouble. Till next time, y'all.